الناس. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. All praise is due to Allah, and may Allah's peace and blessings be upon His final messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Today, inshallah, we'll be interpreting Surat Al-insan, chapter of Insan. Allah starts this chapter by mentioning a fact, saying, هَلْ أَتَى عَلَى الْإِنسَانِ حِيلٌ مِّنَ الدَّهْرِ لَمْ يَكُنْ شَيْئًا مَذْكُورًا. So basically, was there not been a time where man, a period of time when man was not even a thing that was mentioned? So basically, it's a reminder that mankind had a start. So we weren't here. There was a time, there was a start for our creation. And this is just to remind us that we are created. And there is someone who created us. And also a reminder that we're not going to be staying on this earth for all eternity. We'll be living for a fixed period of time. And then we'll be moving along to our next stage. لَمْ يَكُنْ شَيْئًا مَذْكُورًا. He was not a thing even mentioned. SubhanAllah. So this is the reality of our lives. We were at one point something that was not mentioned. Okay, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us. He said in the next verse, Inna khalaqna al-insana min nutfa. First of all, Inna khalaqna al-insana. Indeed, we have created mankind. From what? Min nutfa, a sperm drop. Amshajin, mixed. So, mixed, mixture that is, what is that mixture? It is the... It's the sperm of the man, and what is from the woman is mixed together. This is what amshajin, the mixture in the womb of the mother. Inna khalaqna al-insana min nutfatin amshajin. And then nabtalih faj'alnahu sami'an basira. So again, why were we created? To be tried, to be tested in this earth. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminding us that at one point, we did not exist. And then He created us. Who created? He created. Inna khalaqna al-insan. And then from what did He create us? From the sperm drop. And after that, amshajin nabtali, to test Him. So we were created for a test. This whole life from start to end is a test. Like this other verse that we have covered in Surah Tabarak. What is the verse? That has a similar meaning. That we have Allah Azza wa Jal has created us for a test. First verses. لِنَبْلُوَكُمْ الَّذِي خَلَقَ الْمَوْتَ وَالْحَيَاةَ لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمْلًا. The one who has created life and death to test you, whom amongst you will have the best of deeds. See, these key verses, these are important verses that should be memorized because you'll be needing them. They're very important. You'll be always using them in your arguments. This verse and the one in Tabarak also. إِنَّا خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ مِنْ نُطْفَةٍ أَمْشَاجٍ نَبْتَلِيهِ فَجَعَلْنَاهُ سَمِيعًا بَصِيرًا. Look, we put him, we created him for a trial, to try him. And what? سَمِيعًا بَصِيرًا. Eyesight and hearing. These were gifts from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? For us to enjoy in this world? No. Again, as a test. Why? Because it is with your eyesight. And with your hearing, you will obey Allah. And it's also with your eyesight and with your hearing, you will be sinning. So the sins that you're going to be sinning in this world are also, you won't be able to sin except with the things that Allah has given you. With the eyes that Allah Azza wa Jal has given you, and with the ears that Allah Azza wa Jal has given you, and with the hearing that Allah Azza wa Jal has blessed you with. So these things Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed us with, for what? To test us. Will we be using it for that which Allah has created us for, which is worship, or will we be using it to fulfill our desires and sin? فَجَعَلْنَاهُ سَمِيعًا بَصِيرًا. This is part of the test. He made us hearing and seeing. And then Allah Azza wa Jalla further emphasizes, إِنَّا هَدَيْنَاهُ السَّبِيلَ إِمَّا شَاكِرًا وَإِمَّا كَفُورًا. We have showed him both ways. We have showed him both paths, the path for him to be shakur, thankful, which is worship, and the path of sins. SubhanAllah. And he gave us a choice. Imma shakira wa imma kafura. everyone who will be worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with that that Allah azza wa jalla has given him will be grateful for the blessings that Allah has given you. And everyone who sins with the things that Allah azza wa jalla has given you will be ungrateful. So end of the day, there are two groups. Those who are grateful, who worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and those who are ungrateful, who used these blessings that Allah azza wa jalla has given us to what? To fulfill their desires and subhanAllah, sin, end of the day, and not worship Allah. فَجَعَلْنَاهُ سَمِيعًا بَصِيرًا إِنَّ هَدَيْنَاهُ السَّبِيلَ إِمَّا شَاكِرًا وَإِمَّا كَفُورًا. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about what He has prepared for those who chose disbelief over believing. إِنَّا أَعْتَدْنَا لِلْكَافِرِينَ سَلَاسِلَ وَأَغْلَالًا وَسَعِيرًا. So Allah Azza wa Jal has prepared for the disbelievers. This is just a glimpse of what is prepared. Okay? Chains and shackles. And of course, sa'ira, hellfire. But here, the concentration is about talking about the believers. إِنَّ الْأَبْرَارَ يَشْرَبُونَ. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks here about what He has prepared for His righteous servants. إِنَّ الْأَبْرَارَ يَشْرَبُونَ مِنْ كَأْسٍ كَانَ مِزَاجُهَا كَافُورًا. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions another group. عَيْنًا يَشْرَبُ بِهَا عِبَادُ اللَّهِ يُفَجِّرُونَهَا تَفْجِيرًا. So we have two types of righteous people here. Al-Abrar, the righteous, and Ibadullah, the true servants of Allah. And subhanAllah, Ibn Kathir has also chosen this opinion that Allah Azza wa Jal here is talking about two groups. They're not the same group. The first group, Allah Azza wa Jal referred to them as Al-Abrar from Al-Barr, from good. So those are people who used to do a lot of good. So these are the righteous people. What will they be getting? يَشْرَبُونَ مِنْ كَأْسٍ. Okay, they'll be drinking wine, which is mixed with kafur. So wine mixed with kafur. إِنَّ الْأَبْرَارَ يَشْرَبُونَ مِنْ كَأْسٍ كَانَ مِزَاجُهَا كَافُورًا. Wine that will be mixed with kafur. But, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, عَيْنًا, but that drink will be purely for ibadullah. This is similar to some other verses that we have covered, that Allah Azza wa Jal mentioned. You remember? A verse where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about a specific drink, a mixed, and then talks about the other group will be drinking purely from this drink, without mixing it with anything else. This is a bit difficult. Does anyone remember? طففين. ومزاجها من ت. Come on. جزاك الله خير. جزاك الله خير. يا أخي, if I have a prize, يا أخي, he deserves the prize صراحة. جزاك الله خير. جزاك الله. What is this shit? I know, subhanAllah, where's my students? Shahzad is not here also. And what, you're sleeping? Subhanallah, subhanallah. Yalla, khalas, it's good for him. Jazakallah khair. Yes. ومزاجها من تسنيم. The other verse we mentioned, Allah Azza wa Jal talked about another drink. Tasneem, we said, a drink that will coming from above. It will be mixed for the righteous people, but it will be purely for those of the high levels. Tasneem. And we said tasneem from the word sanam, which means something that is high. And we said the sanam of the ba'ir is the highest part of the ba'ir. Remember this, you remember this. The sanam of the ba'ir is the highest part of the ba'ir, which is the hump. So here Allah Azza wa Jal is also mentioning that the righteous people will be drinking from a drink that is mixed with kafur, a wine mixed with kafur. عَيْنًا يَشْرَبُ بِهَا عِبَادُ اللَّهِ But it will be purely for عِبَادُ اللَّهِ And look at this. Allah Azza wa Jal is praising them by saying عِبَادُ اللَّهِ Servants of Allah, slaves of Allah. We can, subhanAllah, extract so many benefits from this. Number one, the most important thing is that if our priority, our job in this world is to worship Allah, end of the day, whether we like it or not, whether we're talking about believers or disbelievers, we are all slaves of Allah. But those who do their job in this world are praised. They are true slaves. And being a slave of Allah is something praiseworthy. It's something to be praised. It's not something bad. Being a slave of your desires, yeah, this is bad. End of the day, you're a slave. So you choose for yourself. You either be a slave of Allah, the creator, who created you for this, or you be the slave of your desires and your so-called goals in this world. And end of the day, you're going to be leaving, whether you achieved your goals or not, and still wondering about your purpose in this life. While those who are servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they'll be living this life understanding their job in this world. We are here to worship Allah. We are mere servants of Allah. And the more that we worship Allah, the better that we are. The more that we have fulfilled our purpose on this world. So here al-abrar mixed. Ayn and purely for ibadullah, true servants of Allah. Yufajjirunaha tafjira. And the word here, yufajjirunaha tafjira, it will gush forth from wherever they want. Some scholars said of the early, they'll be drinking from this in their palaces. They'll be drinking from this in their gardens. They'll be drinking from this while reclining. It's subhanAllah, something you cannot imagine. It flows, they control the flow of this drink. How? We're talking about the world of the unseen here, but Allah Azza wa Jal has given us the description. The reality of it, nobody knows but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay? But this is something really amazing. عَيْنًا يَشْرَبُ بِهَا عِبَادُ اللَّهِ يُفَجِّرُونَهَا تَفْجِيرًا What were they doing? What did they do in this world? يُوفُونَ بِالنَّذْرِ وَيَخَافُونَ يَوْمًا كَانَ شَرُّهُ مُسْتَطِيرًا Two things. They used to do the acts of worship that was obligated on them. And number two, they used to fear the hereafter. وَيَخَافُونَ يَوْمًا كَانَ شَرُّهُ مُسْتَطِيرًا يَخَافُونَ كَانَ شَرُّهُ مُسْتَطِيرًا They said it will be a long and difficult day, which is the hereafter. Describing it as being, they know for a fact that's going to be a long day. They know for a fact it's going to be a difficult day. كان شره مستطيرا. Okay, النذر here, it has two meanings, but the meaning that scholars have said here, it is the what Allah, نذر means something obligated. And of course, you know in fiqh, the نذر, when a person obligates something on himself, when he says, I obligate myself for Allah, or it is for Allah on me to pray, for example, 100 units, or to give sadaqah of 1,000 dirhams. And the Prophet ﷺ said, don't say this, don't do this. He prohibited us to do nadr. So the ruling for nadr is makruh. We're talking about the fiqh nadr, not the word nadr in the verse. And you know, I just want to give some rulings regarding this. The Prophet ﷺ said, it does not change anything that is decreed. Because some people say, if Allah Azza wa Jal cures my son, khalas, I will be fasting 10 days, or I will be giving sadaqah 1,000. The Prophet ﷺ said, don't say this, it is makruh. But if a person does say this, it's a wajib for him to fulfill the nadr. So this is like, subhanAllah, a puzzling question here. If you go to someone and say, what is in Sharia? The initial ruling is makruh, but once you start it, it becomes an obligation to fulfill. It is nadr. Initially, it is makruh. But if you do that nadr, it's an obligation for you to fulfill. Unless it is something haram. Now, does the verse talk about this nadr? No. Scholars said, a nadr here is general. What Allah has obligated on them, which is the salah, the obligatory salah, the prayer, the zakah, the hajj. This is the nadr. This is why Ibn Kathir combined all these things. He said,
يوفون بالنذر. Okay, he said they fulfill their vows and nadhr, their vows, subhanAllah, the nadhr and the obligatory act of worship. Okay, so basically nadhr in this verse is not specifically the nadhr in fiqh, the vow. Someone says I vow to do this and that, it's no, it's much more general. And in this verse is the obligatory act of worship. Is this clear? Please, you'll be asked about this. خلاص. Okay. وَيَخَافُونَ يَوْمًا كَانَ شَرُّ مُسْتَطِيرًا. Okay. And then look at this. وَيُطْعِمُونَ الطَّعَامِ. They feed the poor. عَلَى حُبِّهِ. What did they mention here? Okay. They said here in the Sahih International, in spite of love for it. They still didn't mention for it what? For the food. Okay. There are two opinions. وَيُطْعِمُونَ. But the preferred opinion is yes. They feed the poor even though they're attached to this food. They need the food. Yet they feed the poor for the sake of Allah. You understand? So it's like giving sadaqah. When you give sadaqah, if someone, that's why they say, give sadaqah while you're still healthy, while you're still young. Why? Because your heart is attached to that wealth. Yet you go and you give it to that poor person. Why? Why on earth would you do this? For the sake of Allah. I fear a day that will be a difficult day, a long day. This is why we're going to be doing this. This is what's making you do the sadaqah. This is why you go out of your way to help people. Why? Because you fear the final day and you do it for the sake of Allah. Okay? وَيُطْعِمُونَ الطَّعَامَ عَلَى حُبِّهِ مِسْكِينًا وَيَتِيمًا وَيَأْسِيرًا. All people who are needy, okay, in general. And then they don't go and say this to the people. إِنَّمَا نُطْعِمُكُمْ لِوَجْهِ اللَّهِ لَا نُرِيدُ مِنْكُمْ جَزَاءً وَلَا شُكُورًا. It's not that they go to the people and say, look, take money, okay, we're doing this for the sake of Allah. No, it's what's in their hearts. What's in their hearts? If somebody wanted to reward them, say, no, we don't need this. We're doing it for Allah. We don't need the reward. We're doing this for the sake of Allah. We don't want any recompense from anyone. Okay? إِنَّمَا نُطْعِمْكُمْ لِوَجْهِ اللَّهِ لَا نُرِيدُ مِنْكُمْ جَزَاءً وَلَا شُكُورًا إِنَّا نَخَافُ مِنْ رَبِّنَا يَوْمًا عَبُوسًا قَمْطَرِيرًا. Again, a long and difficult day. Where did you read the last verse? Fawqahum. You read Fawqahum? Yalla, read. Bismillah. Repeat. How did you pronounce nadra or nadra? Repeat the verse. Fawqahum Allahu. فوقاهم الله شر ذلك اليوم ولقاهم نظرة وسرورا. What did they get from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? They feared that day, that long and difficult day. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rewarded them by protecting them on that day from all the evil of that day, hellfire, and the difficult events that will occur in the day of judgment. And not only that, and they got their reward. It shows that these people are the people of Allah. It shows that these are the special people of Allah. They look different than all the other people with radiant faces. Okay? نَظْرَةً وَسُرُورًا. Their faces happy, filled with happiness. They did the right thing in this dunya. And they know it, that they have passed this difficult test on the day of judgment. And people look at them, they say, those are the lucky ones. These are the true lucky ones, okay? Not the people of wealth who lost all their wealth in this dunya. They came in the hereafter as true losers. They didn't even enjoy the dunya, and they're not going to be getting the akhirah. Those are the people who lost both worlds, subhanAllah.
شر ذلك اليوم ولقاهم نظرة وسرورا وجزاهم بما صبروا.
Okay, and he gave them, he rewarded them for what they have endured in this world, for their patience.
You're not going to be worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as he deserves to be worshipped, except with patience. You have to be patient. That's why they say as-sabr.
The most important part of sabr is being patient in doing the obligations. Some people think about sabr just when calamity strikes. This is where the place of sabr is. Well, actually, the biggest sabr and the most difficult sabr and the greatest sabr is having sabr on worship. Waking up in the morning. Waking up in the morning to pray fajr on time. Trying to go to jama'ah, whether it's hot or it's cold. Subhanallah, you go and do wudu, it's too cold, yet you endure for the sake of Allah. You wake up, well, last night you stayed up all night, yet you still make the effort to wake up in the morning on time for fajr prayer, to go in jama'ah, trying to make it there in the first row. Subhanallah, that's patience. Because you know the reward, you have to work for it. You know that, khalas, Allah has prepared for you something that you cannot imagine. So you endure and you be patient for that reward. بِمَا صَبَرُوا وَجَنَّةً وَحَرِيرًا.
Paradise and silk. I will be talking more about the harira and the other verses.
مُتَّكِئِينَ فِيهَا عَلَى الْأَرَائِكِ لَا يَرَوْنَ فِيهَا شَمْسَ وَلَا زَمْهَرِيرًا.
Okay, they'll be reclining therein on couches. There is no shamsan وَلَا زَمْهَرِيرًا. Does that mean there's no sun? No. It's not going to be too hot and it's not going to be too cold. It will always be a perfect weather. They will always, every single moment you spend in paradise will be for you to fulfill your desires. Nothing is going to worry you. Nothing is going to, subhanAllah, lessen this enjoyment that you have. In this dunya, if it gets too hot, you can't enjoy life. If it gets too cold, you can't enjoy life. No matter what you have, no matter how much you own. Okay? So you're under, subhanAllah, this weather changes everything. If you get sick, it changes everything. In the Jannah, in paradise, you don't get this. Alhamdulillah.
لَا يَرَوْنَ فِيهَا شَمْسًا وَلَا زَمْهَرِيرًا وَدَانِيَةً عَلَيْهَا وَدَانِيَةً عَلَيْهِمْ ظِلَالُهَا وَذُلِّلَتْ قُطُوفُهَا تَذْلِيلًا.
The fruits that they'll be eating will be brought near to them. No matter what situation they are in, they're lying down, they're standing up, the fruits that they'll be tasting, it will be coming close to them, for them to pick up. Subhanallah.
وَذُلِّلَتْ قُطُوفُهَا تَذْلِيلًا
وَيُطَافُ عَلَيْهِمْ. They'll have servants. بِآنِيَةٍ مِّن فِضَّةٍ وَأَكْوَابٍ كَانَتْ قَوَارِيرًا. Look at this verse. Okay. The vessels that they'll be using there will be out of silver. But not any silver.
فِضَّةٍ وَأَكْوَابٍ كَانَتْ قَوَارِيرًا.
It's silver, the material is made out of silver, yet it is qawarir, glass, because you can see through it. It is this pure. It is so much. That's qawarir min fidda. It is pure vessels that you can see through like glass, yet it is made out of silver. Just to show you that this is something that you don't have in this dunya. Allah Azza is giving us examples to show what we'll be getting in paradise. Even the vessels, the things that we'll be using are things you cannot imagine that have, you know, there's nothing like it in this dunya, not even close to it. And they always mention, silver in this dunya is nothing like the silver in the akhirah. The gold in this dunya, the gold in the akhirah, you cannot compare to this gold that we have here. Okay? Like this other hadith, when the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ mentioned, manabir min nur. He mentioned manabir min fidda, manabir min dhahab, and then he said manabir min nur. Subhanallah, a minbar, you know, a platform, or a long chair that you can be sitting on. He mentioned from gold, silver, and then he mentioned out of light. How do you have something made out of light? We don't have something similar to this. Yeah? So that's why they say in paradise, it is, we have things that you cannot compare to anything that we have in this dunya. So this is just to tell you, you have to work for these gifts. You have to work for these rewards.
وَيَسْقَوْنَ فِيهَا كَأْسًا كَانَ مِزَاجُهَا زَنْجَبِيلًا.
Okay, وَقَوَارِيرَ مِنْ فِضَّةٍ قَدَّرُوهَا تَقْدِيرًا. وَيُسْقَوْنَ فِيهَا كَأْسًا كَانَ مِزَاجُهَا زَنْجَبِيلًا. Again, a mixture from ginger. Okay.
عَيْنًا يَشْرَبُ بِهَا عَيْنًا فِيهَا تُسَمَّى سَلْسَبِيلًا.
Again, Ibn Kathir mentioned, there'll be another pure, subhanAllah, fountain
And this will be called salsabil. Everything that we mention in paradise, you have to understand that the people in paradise will be in different levels. Just like they were not the same in this dunya, they will not be the same in the akhirah. Look, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is just. Okay? No one will be oppressed. No one will be oppressed. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can't make two people who are not the same in this dunya, can't make them the same in the akhirah. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is just. That's why He subhanahu wa ta'ala will multiply. Of course, we're talking about the deeds of the hearts also. It might not be evident to us. You might find a person who does a lot of worship, and the other person, in our eyes, doesn't do much worship, yet that person might be higher with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than the other. Remember, for those people who were in Maghrib, remember the hadith that I mentioned? That woman who used to do qiyam and siyam every day, and used to give sadaqah. That's why Aisha, when she mentioned this to the Prophet Muhammad, she was surprised when he said she's going to be in hellfire. She was doing qiyam and siyam and giving sadaqah, yet the Prophet Muhammad said she's going to be in hellfire. Why? Because she used to harm her neighbors. Because she used to harm her neighbors. And subhanAllah, the same hadith, the Prophet Aisha mentioned, it was mentioned to him, a woman who didn't do much qiyam, who didn't do much siyam, and she gave sadaqah, dried milk. It's just something, yani. Yet the Prophet said she's going to be in paradise. Why? Because, alhamdulillah, her neighbors were happy with her. See? So it's not how we judge. It's Allah Azza wa Jalla who's going to be judging the people. And according to their deeds, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make them in different places in paradise. عَيْنًا فِيهَا تُسَمَّى سَلْسَبِيلًا وَيَطُوفُ عَلَيْهِمْ وِلْدَانُ مُخَلَّدُونَ إِذَا رَأَيْتَهُمْ حَسِبْتَهُمْ لُؤْلُؤًا مَنْثُورًا.
You didn't read this, yeah? Did you read this? Where did we stop? Okay, continue reading.
عينا فيها تسمى سلسبيلا. And then Allah Azza wa Jalla said, وَيَطُوفُ عَلَيْهِمْ وِلْدَانُ مُخَلَّدُونَ. The servants, the people of paradise will be having servants. And look at this, Allah did not describe the people of the paradise, He described their servants. So usually, who's well off? Who's more well off? The servants or the owners? Yeah, obviously, the people of paradise. So Allah describes the servants as young boys made eternal, subhanAllah, one age, they will not get old. And مُخَلَّدُونَ إِذَا رَأَيْتَ scattered pearls, scholars have said, because they're busy. They're busy, subhanAllah ta'ala, they're busy in their jobs, taking care of the, you know, the wealth and taking care of the things for the people of paradise. They are busy. And they're scattered because everyone has his own job. That's why they said they're like pearls scattered. I described them as being pearls. So what about the people of paradise? Subhanallah, how will they be? وَإِذَا رَأَيْتَ ثَمَّ رَأَيْتَ نَعِيمًا وَمُلْكًا كَبِيرًا. وَإِذَا رَأَيْتَ ثَمَّ here is هناك. Like, and if you see, if you look there, ثَمَّ there. رَأَيْتَ نَعِيمًا وَمُلْكًا كَبِيرًا. Pleasure and great dominion, subhanAllah, the wealth of the people of paradise. Now look at this. عَالِيَهُمْ ثِيَابُ سُنْدُسٍ خُضْرٌ وَإِسْتَبْرَقٌ. Sundus and istabrak are both types of silk. Both types of silk. Scholars have said, like Ibn Kathir, he said, sundus is the inner garment that they'll be wearing. And istabrak, it's the outer garment. And usually sundus is really soft. And istabrak, it's shiny. So this is the type of garments that the people of paradise will be wearing. We ask Allah to make us of them. عَالِيَهُمْ ثِيَابُ سُنْدُسٍ خُضْرُ وَإِسْتَبْرَقُ وَحُلُّ أَسَاوِرَ مِنْ فِضَّةِ Bracelets of silver. Here, Ibn Kathir said, when we combine the other verses, there will be other bracelets of gold, yeah, and bracelets made out of pearl. He said, this is for a certain level. But those who are higher will get even more things, like bracelets out of gold, yeah, subhanAllah. أساور من فضة وسقاهم ربهم شرابا طهورا. If you studied fiqh, you always find the word. You say الماء طاهر مطهر. Water is described as being pure in itself, and it purifies other things. Here, Allah Subhanahu wa Taala described. So طاهر is something that is pure. Here, Allah Subhanahu wa Taala describes the drink that they'll be drinking in paradise. Tahura, it will purify them. What will they purify them from? Subhanallah. For everything that is bad. All your subhanallah bad characteristics, you'll be purified from that. From lying, cheating, you know, all the diseases of the heart, you'll be purified from all this, from this drink. Khas. Because in paradise, you won't hear anything bad. You won't see anything bad. It's full enjoyment. Okay, as soon as you enter, without any end. Subhanallah. وَسَقَاهُمْ رَبُّهُمْ شَرَابًا طَهُورًا And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ هَذَا كَانَ لَكُمْ جَزَاءً وَكَانَ سَعْيُكُمْ مَشْكُورًا This is a reward. كَانَ لَكُمْ جَزَاءً For what you have done. وَكَانَ سَعْيُكُمْ مَشْكُورًا SubhanAllah, that effort that you have put in will be appreciated. This is enough, knowing that whatever you do, it will be appreciated by Allah. This is enough honor for you as a servant. Knowing that whatever you do in this world, Allah knows it and Allah will appreciate it. Khalas, this whole world means nothing to you if you knew that Allah has appreciated your good deed. If you know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has looked at you when you worship Him and know that He appreciates this effort, thing that I have done for the sake of Allah, subhanAllah, this is enough honor for you. If you leave this world with this, you leave with alhamdulillah, that you have nothing to lose. You've gained everything that is to gain in this world. Why? Because you have found Allah's approval and you know that Allah has appreciated that thing that you have done. وَكَانَ سَعْيُكُمْ مَشْكُورًا Yes.
وَسَبِّحْهُ لَيْلًا طَوِيلًا
Sure. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Inna nahnu nazzalna alayka al-Qur'ana tanzeela. So it is us, Allah Azza wa Jalla, talking about Himself. It is we who have sent down the Qur'an, revelation, tanzeela. So you expect the next verse, if we'll be then be happy with that or appreciate that? No, because with revelation, the thing that you will need is that patience to apply that which Allah Azza wa Jalla has sent down, the Quran. You will need patience. That's why inna nahnu nazzalna alayka al-Qur'ana tanzila fasbir li hukmi rabbik wa la tuti' minhum athiman aw kafura. So be patient for the decision of your Lord, what Allah Azza wa Jalla has decreed for you and what Allah Azza wa Jalla has decreed the Quran. Fasbir li hukmi rabbik wa la tuti' minhum athiman aw kafura. Okay, and do not obey from among them a sinner or an ungrateful disbeliever in sinning. Okay, here, do not obey their commands. Do not obey anyone who's telling you to leave that religion, to disobey Allah. Do not listen to them. وَذْكُرِ اسْمَ رَبِّكَ بُكْرَةً وَأَصِيلًا. Mention the name of your Lord, okay, in prayer, morning and evening. وَمِنَ اللَّيْلِ, during the night. Here it said it is Qiyam, some said Isha and Maghrib. وَمِنَ اللَّيْلِ فَسْجُدْ لَهُ. Prostrate for him, وَسَبِّحُ لَيْلًا طَوِيلًا, and exalt him, okay, a long part of the night. And if you have the past verses, we've heard about paradise that Allah has prepared. So, how do we get there? Be patient and use your time in worship. Okay, invest more in worship. Take advantage of the times that we have. Don't waste them. Okay, as long as in your worship, alhamdulillah, that's good. إن هؤلاء يحبون العاجلة ويذرون وراءهم يوما ثقيلا. Allah Azza wa Jalla pointing to the disbelievers, saying, those people are, subhanAllah, attached to this immediate world, which is the dunya. They are too attached. That's what's stopping them from believing. They're too attached to this dunya. Okay, يحبون العاجلة. Allah describes this world as being العاجلة ويذرون وراءهم يوما ثقيلا. And subhanAllah, they're going to be having a very difficult day, which is the day of judgment. No matter how much they enjoy this world, this will not lessen the torment that they'll be getting the hereafter if they did not do what Allah has commanded them to do. And we have mentioned the hadith again and again, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the day of judgment, will bring the wealth, the most wealthiest of the people of hellfire. On the day of judgment, in this authentic hadith, he will be brought, and he will be taken, and he will be dipped in hellfire. He's not going to stay there for hours. Just one dip, and he'll be taken out of hellfire. And then he will be asked, did you see any good? Did you experience any good, any ease in this dunya? He will say, La ya Rab, I have never seen any good in this dunya. I have never experienced anything in this dunya which was good. Did he lie? No. One dip in hellfire was enough for him to forget everything that he has experienced in this dunya. And he was the wealthiest, the one who had it all easy in this dunya. He remembered nothing of this dunya. And the other person where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take, the poorest and most miserable of the people of paradise in this dunya, he will be taken. He will be dipped in paradise. One dip. They'll be taken out. And then he'll be asked, did you find any hardship in this dunya? Did you experience any difficulties in this dunya? He will say, La ya Rab. SubhanAllah, again, is he lying? Of course not. He forgot this whole dunya with this single dip in paradise. So end of the day, this dunya is irrelevant. Yes, you're living it, you're experiencing difficulties, and some might be, subhanAllah, living a wealthy lifestyle, and they're this way. This dunya is irrelevant. Once you die, and then subhanAllah, once you go to the hereafter, this thing is going to be part, you're not even going to remember anything. But what you're going to see is the deeds that you have put forward, the things that you have invested for this life. So the smart person is the one who will understand what he was created for and will take action and follow and start preparing for that final day.
نحن خلقناهم وشددنا أسرهم وإذا شئنا بدلنا أمثالهم تبديلا.
Okay, we have created them and وَشَدَدْنَا أَسْرَهُمْ. Okay, we have strengthened their forms. Other verses, other, okay, there are other meanings of this. وَإِذَا شِئْنَا بَدَّلْنَا أَمْثَالَهُمْ تَبْدِيلًا. And when we will, we have changed their forms. Again, this verse, as the final, the other verses we mentioned, بَدَّلْنَا, when we have the word بَدَّلْنَا, is to change. بَدَّلْنَا أَمْثَالَهُمْ, we said two opinions, either to change those disbelievers and bring instead of them believers, or to change them, as in resurrect them, in a different form. Yeah, we mentioned those two opinions. وَإِذَا شِئْنَا بَدَّلْنَا أَمْثَالَهُمْ تَبْدِيلًا. And if we have willed, we would have changed those disbelievers and made instead of them believing nations. But it's according to Allah's wisdom that He has created the people as they are to test them. بَدَّلْنَا أَمْثَالَهُمْ تَبْدِيلًا إِنَّ هَذِهِ تَذْكِرَةً فَمَنْ شَاءَ اتَّخَذَ إِلَى رَبِّهِ سَبِيلًا. It's like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, this chapter is a reminder. إِنَّ هَذِهِ تَذْكِرَةً. It's a reminder for you. فَمَنْ شَاءَ اتَّخَذَ إِلَى رَبِّهِ سَبِيلًا. So, you have listened to this reminder. Okay, this chapter is a reminder for you. So, if you will, you will take action and follow and prepare for the hereafter. فَمَنْ شَاءَ اتَّخَذَ إِلَى رَبِّهِ سَبِيلًا. But then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا تَشَاءُونَ إِلَّا أَن يَشَاءَ اللَّهِ. You will not will to take action except with the permission of Allah. Subhanallah. Those who came here to pray, you did that with the permission of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala aided you to do so. Many people who listened to the adhan, similar to you, did not come and pray. Alhamdulillah, you people came and prayed. Allah aided you. And you should be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He aided you to do worship. That's why a Muslim should always say Alhamdulillah, praising Allah. Whatever good that you do, it's with the will of Allah, with the aid of Allah. So you should praise Him that Allah chose you to be Muslims, that Allah chose you to come and pray. Alhamdulillah. Because Allah said, وَمَا تَشَاءُونَ إِلَّا أَن يَشَاءَ اللَّهُ إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ عَلِيمًا حَكِيمًا. These two names together, Alim and Hakim, the knowing subhanahu wa ta'ala and the wise. Allah chooses His servants. You keep on repeating this. Allah chooses His servants. If you're a Muslim, look at the many people who are non-Muslims. Allah chose you. Allah chose your hearts. The same Quran was recited and many people has listened to it. It did not have an effect on many people. Some people, alhamdulillah, they accepted, and they turned to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, accepting that religion, following the message of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Others heard the same Quran, had absolutely no effect, whether we're talking about 1,400 years ago or in these days. Subhanallah, Allah chooses His servants. See, يُدْخِلُ مَن يَشَاءُ فِي رَحْمَتِهِ. Okay, He admits whom He wills into His mercy. What about the oppressors? وَالظَّالِمِينَ أَعَدَّ لَهُمْ عَذَابًا أَلِيمًا. He's prepared for wrongdoers, those who oppress themselves by disbelieving. Who oppress themselves by disbelieving, He has prepared for them a painful punishment. Okay, we still have time. Let's continue. Okay? Tired?
يلا. والمرسلات عرفا فالعاصفات عصفا والناشرات نشرا فالفارقات فرقا فالملقيات ذكرا عذرا أو نذرا إنما توعدون لواقع فإذا النجوم طمست وإذا السماء ويل يومئذ للمكذبين.
حسبك. نتبعهم ونتبعهم. ثم look at the previous page. ألم نهلك الأولين ثم نت okay. بسم الله. Again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala swears start of this chapter by some of his creatures. And we said that when Allah swears by some of his creatures, he swears by them on something important. And also to show these things that are sweared by, to show something specific so that we pay attention to them. And we mentioned that a Muslim does not swear except he wants to swear, he swears by the name of Allah and that's it. Or with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He does not swear by anything else. Not the Prophet, not the Kaaba, nothing. Okay? Prophet said, من كان حالفا فليحلف بالله أو ليصمت. Whoever is going to be swearing, we'll let him swear with the name of Allah or let him be silent. والمرسلات عرفا فالعاصفات عصفا والناشرات نشرا. These three things are the wind. Allah Azza wa Jalla is talking, swearing by the wind, describing something specific in every verse. The first one, عرفa, sent forth in gusts. So, there's something here for God, subhanAllah. Sent forth, okay. وَالْمُرْسَلَاتِ عُرْفَا فَالْعَاصِفَاتِ عَصْفَا. Here, Allah Azza wa Jal is talking about when they blow violently. وَالْنَاشِرَاتِ نَشْرَا. When they scatter and spread the clouds. تَنْشُرْ السَّحَاب. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala swears by the angels. فَالْفَارِقَاتِ فَرْقَ فَالْمُلْقِيَاتِ ذِكْرَ. الْفَارِقَات, here describing them as being فَارِقَات because they will bring a criterion, something that separates truthhood from falsehood. And what is that? What separates between truthhood and falsehood? What is brought by angels that separates between truthhood and falsehood? Huh? You raise your voice, yeah. خلاص. Quran. Be confident. Yes, the Quran. It's revelation. Revelation. Because it separates between truthhood and falsehood. And that's why Al Furqan, Quran has been named as the Furqan, it separates between truthhood and falsehood. So فَالْفَارِقَاتِ فَرْقَ فَالْمُلْقِيَاتِ ذِكْرَى. Okay, and those angels that deliver a message, ذِكْرَى. Revelation is also described as being ذِكْر. Here, ذِكْر is remembrance. And why is revelation referred to as being ذِكْر? Because it should be repeated again and again so that these meanings will be always in the heart. And subhanAllah, the Quran, if you don't memorize, it easily slips away. But there's subhanAllah great wisdom behind this. Because the more that you recite the Quran, the more the meanings will be instilled in your hearts. For those that have, I don't know what to say, yani. For those who don't have dead hearts. Okay, let's put it this way. Because some people might be reciting the same verse again and again and again and not benefiting. Well, the people whose hearts are alive, the more that they recite, the more that these meanings, you know, become, are well established in these hearts. Yeah? And subhanAllah, how many times do we praise Allah every day? When we say, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, do we think about this? We praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala 17 times at least. Okay, in the salah. Subhanallah. In reciting Quran. Do we really think about this? Do we really, does our love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase when we praise Him for everything that He has decreed? So, it's a dhikr. Al-Quran is a dhikr. It could be, should be repeated so that these meanings will be perfectly instilled in our hearts. And then he said, عُذْرًا أَوْ نُذْرًا. The Quran in Revelation is an excuse. Sorry. It is to, so that there is no excuse left. Okay? And it's a warning. Because so that people won't come on the Day of Judgment saying to Allah, no messenger was sent. How we have known that we're supposed to do what we're supposed to do? No. Messengers were sent to every nation with a clear message to worship Allah alone and to leave all false, you know, deities, to worship Allah alone, the true God. Okay? إِنَّمَا تُوَعَدُ عُذْرًا أَوْ نُذْرًا. And then, what is that? We mentioned, Allah swears by these things, that what? إِنَّمَا تُوَعَدُونَ الْوَاقِعِ. Okay, that is that which you are being told about, promised, which is the hereafter, it will definitely occur. When? فَإِذَا النُّجُومُ طُمِسَتْ وَإِذَا السَّمَاءُ فُرِجَتْ. Okay, the stars, طُمِسَتْ, they will go dull, they won't have lights, they'll be destroyed. وَإِذَا السَّمَاءُ فُرِجَتْ, the heavens will be as gates, it will be opened. وَإِذَا الْجِبَالُ نُسِفَتْ, the mountains will be destroyed. وَإِذَا الرُّسُلُ أُقِّتَتْ لِأَيَّوْمٍ أُجِّلَتْ. Okay, here أُقِّتَتْ, they have many meanings, but two meanings, but the main meaning is that they were promised a day, okay, and they are postponed to come as witnesses for that day. يَوْمَ يَجْمَعُ اللَّهُ الرُّسُلُ, as Allah Azza wa Jalla has said, يَوْمَ يَجْمَعُ اللَّهُ الرُّسُلُ فَيَقُولُ مَاذَا أُجِبْتُمْ لِأَيِّ يَوْمٍ أُجِّلَتْ, for what day, okay, it was postponed. لِيَوْمِ الْفَصْلِ, for the day of judgment, فصل. وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا يَوْمُ الْفَصْلِ, and what will make you know what is the day of judgment? وَيْلُ يَوْمَئِذٍ لِلْمُكَذِّبِينَ. What's important is on that day, woe to the disbelievers. وَيْلُ يَوْمَئِذٍ لِلْمُكَذِّبِينَ. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, how did we deal with the first people who disbelieved? We destroyed them. أَلَمْ نُهْلِكِ الْأَوَّلِينَ, have we not destroyed the former people who disbelieved, who opposed the messenger? And they are news to you. You know their news. You know their stories. Okay? They were destroyed. أَلَمْ نُهْلِكِ الْأَوَّلِينَ ثُمَّ نُتْبِعُهُمُ الْآخِرِينَ, and the same will be done to the latter people. Those who will be coming after. There's no difference. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions the previous messengers and how their nations disbelieved. And then he mentions this messenger. Muzzammil. A verse in the Muzzammil. Similar meaning. Surat Al-Muzzammil. Inna arsalna. If he answers before you. Inna arsalna ilaykum. There's Fir'aun. Yes. Raise your voice. No. Inna arsalna ilaykum. I'm saying this verse. Inna arsalna ilaykum. Yes. You have to raise your voice. You're way far back. Yes. Ahsant, Zakallah khair. Sit here. We're sitting in the back. Sit here. So you have all the answers. You sit way back. Sit in front, ya khair. Zakallah khair. Inna arsalna ilaykum rasulan. You know the verse. Inna arsalna ilaykum rasulan shahidan alaykum kama arsalna ila fir'auna rasul. So Allah Azza wa Jalla said in that verse in Surah Al-Muzzammil, we have sent to you a messenger. Inna arsalna ilaykum rasul shahidan alaykum, a witness over you, just like we have sent another messenger to Fir'aun. Kama arsalna Fir'aun fa'asa Fir'aun ar-rasul fa'akhadnahu akhdhan wabila. So Fir'aun, he disobeyed that messenger, we destroyed him. So the same thing is going to happen. So here Allah Azza wa Jalla is saying, alam nuhlik al-awwalin thumma nutbi'u al-akhirin kadhalika naf'alu bil mujrimin. Okay, the same, this is how we deal with the criminals. وَيْلٌ يَوْمَئِذٍ لِلْمُكَذِّبِينَ. SubhanAllah, this warning again and again and again. Woe to the disbelievers. Woe to the criminals. Woe to the disbelievers, the deniers. And then Allah Azza wa Jalla mentions a sign from him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. أَلَمْ نَخْلُقْكُمْ مِنْ مَاءٍ مَهِينَ. Have we not created you from this liquid? مَاءٍ مَهِينَ, sperm drop. فَجَعَلْنَاهُ, where did we put that drop? فِي قَرَارٍ مَكِينَ. فَجَعَلْنَاهُ فِي قَرَارٍ مَكِينَ. A vessel, protected vessel, which is the womb of the mother, subhanallah. That sperm in the womb of the woman, secured, protected, Subhanallah, the perfect environment for creation. Subhanallah. Subhanallah. And this is something you don't have to do anything. Khalas, Allah Azza wa Jalla has taken care of it. Allah controls it even. Okay, في قرار مكين إلى قدر معلوم. It's not by luck, it's not by accident. Everything for a known period. Some 6 months, 7 months, 8 months, 9 months. Decreed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Specific period. إلى قدر معلوم. فقدرنا فنعم قادرون. We have determined, we have decreed. And excellent are we to determine, subhanallah. فنعم القادرون. ويل يومئذ للمكذبين. How do you deny these things? How do you deny these signs? Subhanallah. ألم نجعل الأرض كفاتا أحياء وأمواتا. We not made the earth. They said, the earth is a container or the earth is an envelope. We live on top of it, and when we die, we're below it. We're always around this earth. Always around this earth. أحياء وأمواتا. Living and the dead. So when we're living on this earth. And when we die, we're buried under this earth. So Allah has created this for us, whether we're alive or dead.
وَجَعَلْنَا فِيهَا رَوَاسِيَ شَامِخَاتٍ وَأَسْقَيْنَاكُمْ مَاءً فُرَاتٍ.
We have made, we placed therein, subhanAllah, these mountains as pegs, and we have given you this sweet drinking water. Okay? وَيْلٌ يَوْمَئِذٍ لِلْمُكَذِّبِينَ. SubhanAllah. Again, woe to the deniers. These are signs. Think and contemplate. And then a threat. Woe to the deniers. How do you deny these things? How do you deny these things? Okay. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then says to the disbelievers, mocking them as they used to mock this religion, and disbelieving, saying, انطلقوا إلى ما كنتم به تكذبون. Okay, proceed to that which you have disbelieved. Subhanallah, imagine that. On the Day of Judgment, they're shocked to see everything. Khalas. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to them, proceed to that which you have disbelieved. To what? To all the types of torment and punishments that you disbelieved in. انطلقوا إلى ظل ذي ثلاث شعب. Allah Azza wa Jal here is describing one type of torment. ظل, shadow. ذي ثلاث شعب. They said this flame is so large that it's like three columns, okay? And that smoke is like divided into three. It has, it looks like three different columns from its يعني size. بثلاث شعب لا ظليل ولا يغني من اللهب. Usually, if there was smoke, if there was a shade, then this shade decreases. If you go under the shade, it decreases the temperature. Temperature under the shade is not like temperature, you know, under the sun or under the light. There's a difference, except the shade of hellfire. The shade of that smoke, there will be a lot of smoke. It will have no shade. It will not lessen the punishment. It is punishment in itself. لا ظليل. It will not shade anything. ولا يغني من اللهب. And it will not avail against the flame. Subhanallah. إنها ترمي بشرر كالقصر. Indeed. إنها. Referring to what? إنها ترمي. What is Allah talking about here? إنها. Referring to what? So here it throws sparks. It's referring to, what is throwing sparks? Yes, Zakallah khair. The hellfire. It's throwing sparks. Now usually sparks are like so tiny and insignificant compared to the actual fire. And these sparks, the sparks of hellfire though, they're not so insignificant. إِنَّهَا تَرْمِي بِشَرَرٍ كَالْقَصْرِ. Al-qasr has two meanings. It could either be, you know, at one narration from Sahih Bukhari, Ibn Abbas has said that qasr is, they said, a pillar, a wooden pillar, they used to call this al-qasr. So anything that was large, okay, is called al-qasr. But Ibn Mas'ud said, no, al-qasr, what the meaning is, al-qasr is like the size of a large fortress. This is what the spark is. The spark of hellfire is the size of a large fortress. So what is the size of hellfire? Subhanallah. This is just a spark. إِنَّهَا تَرْمِي. It throws sparks. And these sparks are like fortresses. بِشَرَرٍ كَالْقَصَرٍ. And then describing the color, كَأَنَّهُ جِمَالَةٌ صُفْرٌ. Okay, there's a misconception here. صفر is not yellow. When the Arabs say جِمَالَ, جَمَلْ أَصْفَرُ, or جِمَالَ صُفْرٌ, it's referring to dark black camels. And this is just specific to camels. If the Arab mentioned the same sufr to any other animal, it's yellow. But to camels, it's a common phrase meaning black camels, dark black camels. So Allah is describing the color of these sparks as being dark and black. بِشَرَّ كَالْقَصَرْ كَأَنَّهُ جِمَالَةٌ صُفْرٌ وَيْلٌ يَوْمَئِذٍ لِلْمُكَذِّبِينَ. Like these dark, these will be the size of fortresses, dark. Real dark, okay? وَيْلٌ يَوْمَئِذٍ لِلْمُكَذِّبِينَ هَذَا يَوْمُ لَا يَنْطِقُونَ. They will not, this is a day they will not speak. وَلَا يُؤْذَنُ لَهُمْ فَيَعْتَذِرُونَ. If you want to ask forgiveness, you will not be allowed to even talk and ask for forgiveness and give their excuses on that day. Now who can tell me, how do you combine the meaning of this verse with the other verses that says that, you know, they'll be giving their excuses and it will not be accepted from them? I guess, subhanAllah, I was asked this question many times. Does anyone know? Because we have another, we mentioned, yeah, when we talked about the hereafter, people will be arguing, yeah, and we said that the hands will be talking against, will be arguing against them, and their skin, we're giving testimonies against them. So there will be some denying. So how do you combine the meanings of this verse and the other verses? Yes, raise your voice. Okay, you mean that it will, but here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَا يُؤْذَنُ لَهُمْ فَيَعْتَذِرُ. They will not be even given, they will not be permitted to give an excuse. So how do you combine this? Yes, this is the other, but here, it's there. Okay, but in other, okay, we know that health, the day of judgment, there are many events. There are many events, okay, that will occur, yeah? It's not just one part. Many things will happen. Remember that what we said? It's like resurrection, and then after that, they'll be gathered, and then after that, you know, they'll be taking the books, and then there'll be the scales, and then there'll be the hisab, yeah? Hisab yasir, hisab asir, yeah? And then there'll be... So there are many different events. On some occasions, they'll not be allowed to talk. Okay? And on some other occasions, they'll be asked questions for them to talk. You remember those who will be having Hisab Asir? You'll be asked deep questions. Why did you do so? And this, why? And we said that those who will be having a difficult recompense, they'll be tormented for sure. Because they have no excuse. So they'll be saying these things, but they don't have any excuses. So the answer is that it depends. Hereafter, the Day of Judgment, there'll be many events, many situations. In some places, sometimes they'll be given a chance to talk, okay? And other times, they won't. This is how we combine the meanings. Did you understand? Yes? Understood?
وَلَا يُؤْذَنُ لَهُمْ فَيَعْتَذِرُونَ
SubhanAllah, also, look at this. يعني, this is the day, خلاص, that you're silent. Allah has had enough from your excuses on that day of judgment. You will not be allowed even to give any excuses. Because you have no excuses, aslan. What are you going to say? You have no excuse. Everything was given for you. SubhanAllah.
وَلَا يُؤْذَنُ لَهُمْ فَيَعْتَذِرُ وَيْلُ يَوْمَئِذٍ لِلْمُكَذِّبِينَ هذا يوم الفصل جمعناكم والأولين.
So we have gathered all the first people, assembled all the people, okay? The first and the last. فإن كان لكم كيدٌ فكيدون. So if you have a plan, if you have the strength, okay, to run away, to flee, to plan something, plan and plot. Who are you going to be planning and plotting against Allah, the Creator, on that day of judgment? SubhanAllah. ويل يومئذ للمكذبين. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions the other group, the believers. إن المتقين فيه ظلال وعيون. Just like the people of hellfire will be tormented, even the shade is torment, the shadow is torment. No, people of paradise, they'll be under shades and under springs, enjoying their life, alhamdulillah, وَفَوَاكَ مِمَّا يَشْتَأَنْ, fruits from whatever they desire. كُلُوا وَاشْرَبُوا هَنِيئًا بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. Eat and drink, okay, and enjoy, okay, as a reward for you have for what you have put forward. Inna kadhalika najzi al-muhsinin. That's our opinion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The doers of good. Alhamdulillah, the good deeds that you have done in this dunya, nobody knows of it. You don't need to tell anyone. Allah knows of it. And you'll be rewarded for that, alhamdulillah. And you'll be happy with this. Allah will not forget you. Allah will appreciate everything that you have done. Inna kadhalika najzi al-muhsinin. Concentrate on being of the people of ihsan, being of the doers of good, that Allah Azza wa Jalla will reward you. But on the other hand, وَيْلُ يَوْمَئِذٍ لِلْمُكَذِّبِينَ. Instead, كُلُوا سُفْ. The people of paradise, Allah did not mention their situation in the dunya. Whether they're hungry, whether they were eating, whether they were rich or they were irrelevant. In paradise, they'll be enjoying their life. The people of hellfire, on the other hand, as I say, best case scenario, was they're enjoying their lives. Okay, if you're enjoying your lives in this dunya as a disbeliever, fine. كُلُوا وَتَمَتَّعُوا إِنَّكُمْ مُجْرِمُونَ. Eat and drink. But indeed you are criminals, meaning that regardless of what you eat and drink, this will not relieve you of what's going to be happening on the Day of Judgment. وَيْلُ يَوْمَئِذٍ لِلْمُكَذِّبِينَ. Woe that day to the deniers. And what is said to them, pray, bow in prayer. وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ رَكَعُوا لَا يَرْكَعُونَ. لَا يَرْكَعُونَ. They disobey and they do not follow. ويل يومئذ للمكذبين. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ends this chapter with this verse. فبأي حديث بعده يؤمن. What's after the Quran and the admonition of the Quran and the reminders of the Quran will they believe? If they do not believe in this, there is no other sign. Okay, if the Quran did not have the effect, nothing will. End of the day, it is the Quran. So in what statement? After the Qur'an will they believe? What is better than the Qur'an? The Qur'an is the word of Allah. Nothing is better than the Qur'an. Okay. With this, alhamdulillah, we have finished the two juz. And inshallah, regarding next week, inshallah for those who are in the group, inshallah we'll see what's going to be happening next week. Will we continue? We'll be taking a break because there's going to be an exam for those who are with the seekers program. So inshallah, stay tuned. We'll update you in the group, inshallah. If there's going to be a lecture next week, you'll be told in the group, okay? Make sure to, if you're not in the group, just join, huh? هذا والله أعلم وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. جزاكم الله خير.